One of the most frustrating things when learning Adobe Illustrator is trying to create seemingly simple shapes, but not knowing which tools to use. And being able to create a variety of shapes, whether you're designing a suite of icons, a website, or perhaps a poster, is pretty much essential for every designer. So today we're going to create 9 different shapes, many of which you may recognize. And if you're new to Illustrator, well, this video is about to make your life a whole lot easier. And just for fun, if you do decide to have a go yourself, let me know how many you get right down in the comments. And spoiler, I've saved the best till last. This video is also sponsored by Skillshare, and first up, let's start with a sparkle. So first of all, grab the ellipse tool and then click and drag. Remember to hold shift so you get a perfect circle. Let's make sure the fill color is none. And we're going to thicken up that stroke weight. And believe it or not, we're almost done. So all we need to do now is go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and select Pucker and Bloat. Now just grab the slider and drag it towards pucker, depending on how sparkly you'd like your sparkle to be. And then when you're happy, click OK and press Shift X to swap the fill and the stroke color. And technically this is still a circle with an effect. To apply that effect, select Expand Appearance. And now it's a true sparkle. Okay, next up, a water droplet. So again, we're going to start with a circle. And for this one, we're going to move it down a bit and then go and select the Direct Selection tool. Drag over that top anchor point and then drag this up. And make sure you do hold down shift or it will go all kinds of wonky. And there we go, bonus shape, an egg. And once you have an egg-like shape, hold Alt or Option and click and drag on this handle. And you can use this to adjust of all we're going with the droplet. Now I'm going to drag mine into the middle. You can see it snaps with those smart guides. And again, holding Alt or Option, I can click and drag on the other handle and position this exactly on top of the other one, just so they're perfectly symmetrical. And if you get any weird glitches like that bit at the top, don't worry, just jump into outline mode with Command or Control Y. Illustrator will suddenly wake up and sort itself out. Now, lastly, I'm going to grab the eraser tool and I'm just going to erase that top bit so my water droplet isn't so pointy. There we go, let's just flatten that top bit. And then select the shape with the direct selection tool and click on those control points to round off the top. And to be honest, this is the kind of shape that you can stretch a bit if you want, like you'll probably get away with it, and you can use this to refine the shape of your droplet. Right, now it's time to create a heart shape, and there's a ton of different ways to do this, and there's equally a ton of different ways that this can go very wrong indeed. But we're gonna do it the right way. So for this technique, we're going to go and grab the pen tool, and then let's find the center of the artboard, and click and drag holding shift. Make sure those handles run in a vertical line, and then it will want to continue this curve, and then hover over here until you see your smart guides mark a 90 degree angle. And then go to the right ever so slightly. Now again, click and drag holding shift, and the goal here is to line up those top two control points. Now, if you let go of the mouse, it wants to continue that curve, and you can simply click on that last anchor point to cut that. There we go. And then click on the first anchor point to close the shape. And there we go, that is the hardest part done, and we now have half a heart. So for the next step, make sure that this shape is selected, and then select the Reflect tool, and hold down Alt or Option and click on that bottommost anchor point. Make sure you're reflecting along the vertical axes and then select Copy. This gives us a perfectly symmetrical heart, and all we have to do now is select both halves, let's swap the fill and the stroke, and then select Unite from the Pathfinder panel. And this will combine those two shapes into one shape. Now, creating arrows might seem simple, and it is. You just create a line and a triangle, right? Well, yes, but there's a better way to create arrows that will give you a lot more flexibility. Unlike me. Right, so for this one, first of all, we're going to start with the line segment tool. Click and hold shift to draw a horizontal line. Now, of course, being a line, it doesn't need a fill color, and let's thicken it up maybe a bit more so we can actually see it clearly. There we go, let's go for 100, why not? And if you click on the word stroke alongside, it will open up the stroke panel with a ton of different properties. And one of these properties are arrowheads. So I'm going to choose arrowhead 7. I quite like this one. It's a bit big and it's pointing the wrong way. So let's set that to none. And instead, I'm going to select this drop down and I'm going to add that to the end. Now, as I mentioned, it is absolutely giant. So let's link the width and the height and then adjust the scale. There we go. Let's bring that down to something more acceptable. There we go. Very good. And from the stroke panel, we can also change the width profile. So let's select this one here that tapers off to a point. And you can use the icons alongside to flip it round the other way. And remember, all of these stroke properties are still tied to a single line. So if we go up here and select the anchor point tool, and we can now click and drag on this line, and not only the line, but the arrowhead and all of those stroke properties adjust with it. And just before we move on to the next one, thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. And if you haven't heard of Skillshare, it's the largest online learning community with thousands of classes for creatives that are led by industry pros across film, illustration, design, freelance life, productivity, and a lot more. And the classes are all on demand so everyone can learn at their own pace. Me, for example, I've used Skillshare to get better at drawing, and more recently I've completed one of their learning paths, which is essentially a hand-picked curation of several related classes. And the one I did was called Creative Productivity, Kickstart and Sustain Any Project. There were 6 classes in total, and the one by Thomas Frank on Building Habits That Last, that one was especially helpful. And this class is just packed full of very actionable advice that has really helped me to build better habits and get more done in less time. So if that sounds good and you'd like to start learning today, the first 500 people to use my link in the description will get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare. Okay, next up, let's create a shield. Now again, for shields, there's a lot of different ways to create this. For this example, I'm going to select the pen tool and then click in the middle and draw a diagonal line, and then create another point down the bottom and make sure that it vertically lines up with that first one. And if you switch to the selection tool, it will discontinue that path. Now again, let's thicken everything up so we can see what we're doing. And once again, I'm going to use the anchor point tool with Shift and C on the keyboard. And then I can click on each of these lines in turn and bend the shield into the exact shape that I'm looking for. Yeah, so something like that looks good. Next, I'm going to select this half and switch to the Reflect tool. Hold Alt or Option and click. Reflect this vertically. Remember to select Copy. And now we can drag over both halves. And if we hold down Alt or Option and click and drag from one of the corners, we can resize this centrally. And there we go. I think that's looking pretty good. Now, the last thing we need to do is switch to the Direct Selection tool, drag over the top 2 points and then the bottom 2 points, and press Command or Control J to join these anchor points. Lastly, let's swap the fill and the stroke, and we now have our completed shield. Now, you'll definitely recognize this next one. It's the infamous special offer Starburst shape, the kind of thing you've probably seen on posters and flyers since you were a kid. Right, let's use a different tool now. We're going to go over to the toolbar and we're going to select the star tool. And if we click and drag in the center, this will create a 5-pointed star by default. However, we can use the up and down arrow keys on the keyboard to adjust the number of points. However, what we can also do is hold down Command or Control and click and drag towards or away from the center. And this will enable us to adjust essentially how pointy each of these points are. And then once you've fine-tuned your shape, remember to hold down Shift so it sits perfectly straight. And in the more recent versions of Illustrator, you can grab this control point that enables you to adjust the number of points even after you've created the shape. Now for this next one, we're going to create a linear or Archimedean spiral, and this is where the space between each line in the spiral is a consistent width. And this is especially useful because you can't use Illustrator spiral tool to create this shape. So for this one, we're going to start by selecting the line tool, click and hold, and then select the polar grid tool. And whilst clicking and dragging, you can use the left and right arrow keys to adjust the number of radial dividers and the up and down arrow keys to adjust the number of concentric circles. And before letting go of the mouse, remember to hold Shift so you get a perfect circle. And let's pop this in the middle. There we go. Now we're going to switch to the direct selection tool and then just drag over the top half of all of these circles. Press delete or backspace to remove. And with the remaining lines selected, switch to the reflect tool and then hold Alt or Option and click on that topmost point. Switch the reflection axes to horizontal and select copy. Now all we have to do with the main selection tool is grab those copied lines and drag them one line to the right. And there we go. That is a linear or Archimedean spiral. Okay, this next one, I wasn't sure what to call it, so in my notes, I just wrote down lollipop swirl thing, so yeah, you'll see what I mean. Okay, so using what we learned in the previous step, start with something like this, go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and select Twist. And whilst this is one way to do it, I'm going to show you two. This is the first one, and you can increase the angles and create something like this. And actually, you can get pretty creative with this and create some rather cool patterns, but this isn't the lollipop swirl that was promised. So I just wanted to show you that, but now let's go back to a circle. And I'm going to select said circle, and then select the Line Segment tool. Now I'm going to click on that top center anchor point, and then hold Shift and drag down to create a vertical line. Now let's select that line, and then go and grab the Rotate tool. And with this tool selected, press Enter or Return. And I'm going to have 3 lines in total. So let's do 360 degrees divided by 3. Again, remember to select Copy. And we can repeat that transform with Command or Control D. Now we need to make sure we select just the lines and not the circle around the edge. And then with these selected, go to Effect, down to distort and transform, and select twist. And if we increase the angle, you'll see that we gradually get something a bit more akin to a traditional lollipop. And you can of course add as many lines and swirls as you like. Now, I said I'd save the best till last, and that is because this shape is a coil. Good luck. And this one might seem easy, but it can catch you out. So first of all, let's select the ellipse tool, and we're actually going to create an ellipse this time. Then let's switch to the direct selection tool, drag over that left anchor point and delete that left half. Now let's select the remaining half, switch to the reflect tool, and then hold alter option and click. Now again, make sure that vertical is checked and select copy. So effectively now we have an ellipse made up of two halves. And with the main selection tool on that left half, I'm going to squish this down a bit. So for this to work, you should have something that looks like this. Now let's join them together by selecting both lines and pressing Command or Control J. That's the shortcut for join. And then if I move this down, I can then hold Alter Option and Shift and drag this up. Let's just eyeball it for now, this is fine. And then press Command or Control D to repeat that transform. And there we go, just like that, we've created a coil. Or a spring. Regardless, whatever you want to call it, we've done it. So hopefully you enjoyed that. How many did you get right? Remember to let me know down in the comments. A big thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video, and of course to you for watching. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you in the next one.